Hi everyone! In last week's video, I showed you how to make seamlessly repeating patterns of your art for print-on-demand shops like Redbubble and Society6. Today, we'll take that a bit further and make an offset or diagonal repeating pattern. The beginning of making the pattern is exactly the same for both styles. I'll use two paintings for the pattern. They're oil paintings I've scanned and edited already, and I've also removed the background. You can see those steps in my previous videos, which will be linked somewhere on this video. I'm using Photoshop CC 2020 to make the repeating pattern, and if you don't have Photoshop yet, you can start a free 7-day trial. The link is on the video or below. I opened the artwork in Photoshop and made a bigger canvas for the repeating unit that's about twice the size of the original image. So the original was 1500 square pixels and the new one is 3000. Drag the artwork over to the new empty canvas, move it to about the middle of the canvas, then go to Filter, Other, Offset. Set the horizontal and vertical pixels to half the dimensions of the document and make sure that the wraparound option is checked. If you need to check the dimensions of the document, you can find them in the bottom left corner. And now, to turn this into an offset or diagonal repeat pattern, we need to move some parts around. Add guides by going to View, New Guide Layout. Set the columns and rows to 2 and click OK. Make sure the selection tool snaps to these guides by having View, Snap checked. Take the rectangular selection tool and draw a selection for the top left square. Press Ctrl X to cut out the selection and Ctrl V to paste the selection into a new layer. Do the same with the bottom left square. And now swap these layers around. They'll snap to the horizontal center guide and to the edges. Now you'll add the other image in the middle by opening it in Photoshop and dragging it over to the pattern. I made a mistake in placing the second bird here. Did you catch what it is? I'll let you know later. Save this pattern as a PNG file for print-on-demand sites like Redbubble, where you can just style this with the offset repeat setting, and also save it as a PSD file, which preserves the layers so you can do any adjustments later, which I did have to do with this one. For other print-on-demand shops such as Society6, you might need to style the pattern before uploading, so I'll show you how to do that. Make a new, larger image. I'll go with 1500 square pixels, cause that's the size that works for most products on Society6. And make sure the View, Snap to Guides option is checked. Add guides by going to View, New Guide Layout. Calculate how many rows and columns you should do. My pattern is 3000 square pixels and the empty canvas is 15000 square pixels, and 15000 divided by 3000 is 5, so I'll do 5 columns and rows. Then, once again, drag over the PNG image of the pattern onto this new canvas. It should snap into place. Then, just copy the layer by right-clicking the layer and selecting Duplicate Layer. For the first column, you'll add the pattern units into the grid normally, but for the second column, you have to snap it so that the center of the pattern unit matches the horizontal guideline. So duplicate the layer a bunch of times and then place them correctly using the guides. This probably isn't the most effective way to do it if you're filling a large area, but it's one way to get it done. So, did you notice the mistake I made? I realized the branch of the second bird painting was cut off on the right. This is why you want to save the PSD files of different steps. So now I can go back to the file where I placed two birds together and move that bird so that the branch is visible in full. Or I could place that layer underneath the other bird if I wanted to, so you can't see the branch cutting off. You can play with the layers, decide which one is in the front and which one in the back. And finally, add a new layer from the plus sign, move it underneath the other layers and fill it with background color, and save as JPEG for Society 6. If you'd like to see more image editing and print-on-demand tips, click on the videos on the screen. Thanks for watching. Bye!